Hi everyone and welcome back to the special edition of PMAC 2025 interview. With me is Mr. Wang Jian. He's the keynote speaker of this year's meeting. He's also the chairman and co-founder of Beijing Genomics Institute. What inspired you to start the BGI group?
Well, that time we were in the United States. A bunch of friends of mine, we were doing our postdoc training there. And then when the US government started the Human Genome Project, there was a big impact on us. We thought that would be the future for the medicine, for the health. So probably for us, it's a good chance to join that. So we went back to China to try to convince our government to support this project. We tried to push the Chinese to catch up with the Human Genome Project.
Can you tell our audience what was the original purpose of the Human Genome Project?
Okay, for many years, we know that we are the human beings, we are different with the monkeys, the animals. What's the genome construction? Mm. What's the gene looks like? Nobody answered this question. Mm. So I think it's 1984 or 85, the US scientists proposed we should have the standard or reference genome map for the human society. So that's why, that's how the US started that. Then the US government turned this project to an international project. Mm. So for us, for the big population, China, we're thinking we need our own reference and a map. So that's why we raised hands, wants to join the US, started the genome project.
When did this start? In 1990s?
The US started, initiated this project officially as 1990.
Right.
And we talked about this to bring back to China is right after that. But we took us a couple of years to prepare. Mm. So first I went back to China in 1994. And we really started and talk about and started that was 1997.
If I remember correctly, back then they say it's going to take 10 plus years to be able to map the genome of one human person, correct? Many years and cost quite a lot.
Well, the first the scientists proposed that for 30 years.
To complete the one genome?
to finish that one.
Wow.
They proposed the one base pair, one dot. So that totally got to be 30 years. And $30 billion.
All right, because it's lots of genome pairs. Yeah. I mean, the base
pair. Yeah, it's $3 billion.
Wow.
Okay. Till now, this project has become an international project.
Right.
And there's more people joining, and it's a little bit speed up, especially the private company.
If you were to do this project again, how many years would it have taken, and how much money you would have taken?
Right now?
Yes, right now.
Half days.
Half a day.
It's less than $100.
Half a day, less than $100 for it used to be 13 years and $3 billion.
Yes,
Wow.
No, it's very fast.
Technology is very amazing.
The machines, they call the capillary sequencer. Mm. They only can produce thousands base pair and then upgrade to the million, 1 or 2 million, this is the maximum at that time. And then the short read sequence by synthesize technology coming, there was 2006 or 7. And then they will speed up very quickly. We started to make our own machines. Now we have the short read sequencer, long read sequencer, even the semiconductor sequencers.
So chip based.
Yeah, chip based. So we are the only one have the three technology together, and we are the very efficient, effective machines. And so we have the high super, high quality, low cost system for the DNA research and clinical applications.
Well, you mentioned many times in your keynote speech that there's something called R-omics.
Okay.
What is that exactly?
We have to go back to see this, the whole progress in medicine. Yeah. The first law for the diagnosis is chemical based.
Okay.
And it was 100 years ago.
Right.
And then it was still there, from chemical to biochemical.
Mm.
Okay. And then to the molecular biology. That was 70 years ago. And first, James Watson, those guys, the discovery,
the
DNA construction, and then they started the molecular biology time.
Correct.
And then comes to the 80s, 90s, the genome comes, and the protein omics, all this omics, just made the name, so all mixed.
Okay, all mixed.
All mixed.
Okay, but also with the mention of like AI processing,
data processing.
On top of this kind of molecular science, correct?
Yes, AI is artificial intelligence, but for the biology things, there's lots of things we haven't discovered yet.
Mm.
So that's why we need the tools, machines, high super low cost, to get all this data to the table.
Mm.
We need the omics. So we like to say that from the artificial intelligence will switch, upgrade to the bio-intelligence.
Mm.
That's our goal.
If you want to translate this into something that people can understand, how would you benefit from your omics?
Life is so complicated, from the spur, from far side,
uh-huh.
the egg from Mars side, 1 + 1 = 1,
mm-hmm.
and it become a fertilized egg.
Mm-hmm.
And then 1 × 2 = 4, mm-hmm. 8, blah, 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 and become the 4 individual
mm-hmm.
persons. And then there's lots of molecular changes, but the genome never changed.
Mm-hmm.
So genome is not changed, so there's lots of genetic diseases through genetic pains.
Correct.
And if we know this information, we know that all the birth defect, before the baby born, we know there's going to have something happens.
Mm-hmm.
So it's very important to use the genome technology to know the genetic disease. For example, in Thailand, in the southern countries of the world,
mm-hmm.
there's lots of genetic diseases, especially for the thalassemia.
Correct.
And right. Thailand and Indonesia, Malaysia is a big problem.
Mm.
Now we can early detect, to figure out what's the carrier, the positive carrier, what's the possibility for their childhood.
So you
next generation.
Right. So advocating genetic testing at what age?
Well, before the marriage, it's a good one.
Before they have kids. Yes.
Yeah. If the looks normal.
Right. But you never know.
You never know.
Correct.
Maybe you are the carrier of whether you are not that serious disease, but it's okay. You can survive.
Mm.
But you come up to the sports, you're not that good.
Mm.
Probably you are genetically it's not good.
But are you afraid that this kind of information will be used to discriminate some people, for example?
Sure.
Right? Let's say I want to be a runner.
Yeah.
But my genetic doesn't have a strong muscle or fast muscle.
Yeah.
So I can never become a runner. Is that something gonna happen?
Yes. Well, it's private is more important.
Mm.
Just like you have money in the bank, it's your privacy.
Correct.
And that your genome data is your privacy.
Right.
We never touch it.
Ah.
We just give it to you, and we don't write your name somewhere. And it's your property.
Right.
Even more important than the money is.
Yeah.
And the second thing is, if there's no DNA changes, variations, all these kind of disorders, there's no cancer.
Right.
Because the DNA changed.
Right.
And they were finally, they got the cancers. So all this infection disease is the genes from the outside infect you.
Correct.
Okay. The genetic disease is from your families or during the development or something.
Correct.
And the cancers is a gene change.
Right.
And for the cardiovascular disease, some people, let's say if we are live the same lifestyle conditions, sometimes I am someone more sensitive to the cardiovascular disease, someone are not. So there's the lifestyle, metabolics, all those kinds, it's more complicated.
I was very fascinated by your speech because I'm a cardiologist.
Okay.
So you mentioned that you have changed your risk factors.
Yes.
Because you have your genetic information.
Yes, yes. Right?
What have you done to yourself, basically?
Well, I was thinking, can I do the gene editing to myself?
Uh-huh.
But I said, it's too complicated. Forget about it. Right. Just use the chemical to lower the
cholesterol, blood pressure.
Pressure on glucose to keep lower the blood pressure, so I can reduce the atherosclerosis particle.
What have you done to your lifestyle? Have you you exercise more? You lose weight? What do you do too?
Well, if I eat more, I do more exercise.
Okay.
If I control my diet, that's fine. I can be lazy life.
Yeah.
Just check your blood. See the bad things. It's not too high.
Right. In your company, you turn off the elevator so that your employee have to walk up and down the stairs. Is that true?
Not all of them.
Not all of them. Okay.
So if you're strong enough, you can take
the flight of stairs. Yes. True.
If you're too weak, and you have to do more exercise. But people are lazy. They just push a button and go there. So before 1 month ago, we decided to close most of the elevator. But not for the guests.
Uh-huh.
Okay, not for the real pregnant.
Right, understand. People who can't, who need to use it.
Yeah, people need to use that, but they have to walk to there.
Yeah.
And we have a huge building. We have 24 elevators.
Oh, okay.
We shut down something like 18 or something.
Wow, that's nice. You save money and make people stronger. Did your employees complain?
Yes,
they did.
But afterwards, they feel so good.
Oh,
yeah. They get used to it.
That's good.
People are lazy.
Yeah, that's good. I heard that your company actually branched out to do things like genetic mapping of animals, like chicken. Also some plants and some rice and things like this, is that correct?
We contribute almost more than 60% of the economically important plants and animals to the world.
Right.
So we are the biggest contribution.
Right. Is this kind of things open source, meaning can people...
Sure.
Wonderful.
Well, if we did that, it's fee for service for fee, and that data is not belongs to us. The company, they have the final word. If we work for the public sector, we just to make it available for the work.
And I heard also that in your company you aim for a couple of things, like no cancer that detect later than in the
hospital.
Right.
That means we are better than hospital.
Correct.
For the early diagnosis.
Correct. What else?
But not for treatment.
Of course, I understand. For detection, that means you can detect early.
Yes.
Right before it manifests into clinical disease. Right.
Yeah.
And what else were your goals for the
company? There's no sudden deaths from the cardiovascular disease.
Oh, you put me out of job.
Yeah.
No job for me. That's okay. That's fine. Yeah. That's good. That's good.
Everybody wants it.
That's
right?
Good. Yes, of course.
For the genetic disease, for the lung QT.
Right.
We check it for free for everyone.
Very good.
And we have that image checkup.
Good.
To see the atherosclerosis thing.
Yes.
Good. And there's some bad construction that since happens. What's called the domain, I don't know what the English.
Okay.
So we make the people do the early diagnosis and prevention and controlling and lift the hard job for you guys.
Right.
And now we are working with the Chinese Heart Associations.
Wow.
Because the leader of the cardiovascular surgery, they need to do this heart transplantations.
Right.
There's so many.
Yeah.
So why not move
earlier to prevent?
To prevent.
Yes.
They even make it an artificial heart. They make lots of money, but they don't want it.
Mm. On a personal note, if you guys don't know, Mr. Wang Jian actually went to the North Pole, went to the South Pole, went to the Everest, and went to the Challenger's Deep, the deepest point in the world. Why do you do these things?
Well, we had, tell you the results. We already have more than 200 high quality publications for this. Four extreme
areas?
Yeah, areas.
Environments?
Yeah. For the research,
we
sequenced the penguin, polar bear, and the shrimp from the South Pole, of all this kind of things.
Oh, so more like a work
research,
trip than research trip,
research,
rather than rather than just a trip?
It's just, no, I don't do that. But for me, it's a good excuse to take a trip.
Yeah.
Otherwise, cannot leave the job.
Yeah.
So we are going to have a special issue in cell in next couple of months. It's a deep sea discovery. We add 6.9% of new bacteria strains to the database worldwide.
Wow.
In one shot, get more, almost 7%. And we found that 24% of new virus for the whole world. So there's lots of discovery, and I took the blood every 1,000 meters high for the high altitude sickness research.
Wow.
So I'm serious research.
Wonderful. It sounds like a very interesting life.
That's good. I like it.
I think you did well. I think you did well. Well, thank you so much for being with us today and sharing your life work with us. And I hope to see you again in Thailand soon.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you.